Welcome to Hertford Church of England High School Virtual Commendation Day 2020. Today's ceremonies will be a little different to usual, not least because we are not sitting in our school hall in 27 degree heat in our blazers, and I have no doubt that many of you are more than a little relieved you won't have to walk up on stage to collect your certificates. But your Commendation Day is important to us as a school community. Today we are celebrating your wonderful achievements over this academic year. This year has brought many new challenges to face, but you have, as ever, risen to the occasion, and we are incredibly proud of what you have all achieved. We will begin with a visit to the beautiful new library in the Veritas building, where our Chair of Governors, Mr. Jeremy Huns, will welcome you all.
Hello, my name's Jeremy Huns, and on behalf of the governing body, it's my very great pleasure to welcome all of you, students, parents, carers and staff alike, to our first virtual Commendation Day. You don't need me to tell you we're living in extraordinary times as we seek to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic, and we've all had to change, adapt and learn all sorts of new skills, to say nothing of a whole new vocabulary. Who heard of Zoom meetings before all this started? Today is all about celebrating your achievements and hard works achieved under very different and unusual circumstances. Some of you will have found these changes harder to adapt to than others, but as a governing body, we're immensely proud of the efforts you've all made to maintain your focus and engagement with your studies. And although it may not seem like it, many of the skills you've learned since lockdown, such as the ability to study and to work independently and how to use technology to help you learn, will prove to be very useful later in your education and through your working lives. Today is about celebrating your achievements, and don't let anyone look down on you because you were the COVID year students. We none of us know how this pandemic's going to progress and what the impact of COVID-19 is going to be on education in the coming years. But the lesson from this year has to be that each one of you need to focus on doing the best, the absolute best you can during your time here at Hertford Church of England High School. Now, whilst today is about celebrating your achievements and your successes, none of this would be possible without the hard work and dedication of Mr. Holland, the teaching staff, and all the hard work and dedication of the support staff as well. They've all had to learn very quickly and embrace all sorts of different technologies, to say nothing of dealing with vast quantities of paperwork. So I'd like you all to join with me and the governors in thanking Mr. Holland and all of the staff here at Hertford Church of England High School for all their hard work and dedication. So having expressed our thanks to Mr. Holland and all the staff, I'm now looking forward to hearing and enjoying all your successes. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Huns. And now to our fantastic drama studio, and I'm delighted to welcome our head teacher, Mr. Holland.
Welcome to our virtual Commendation Day. I'm so sorry that we can't hold this ceremony in school, as we have so much to celebrate together. Thank you for the contributions of Mr. Huns, our Chair of Governors, Ms. Stanley and Reverend Smith, our Vice Chairs of Governors, your Heads of House, and our fantastic musicians. I'm speaking to you from the drama studio. I wanted to stand in the hall and do this as I normally would, but the sound would have been far too echoey. I'm well aware that some of you will choose to skip this section and get straight to the prize winners. You may even be tempted to put me on double speed to get me over with more quickly. If you choose to do either of these things, I will know. This year's theme can only be educational and other lessons from lockdown. Whatever we've learned, we've always known. It's just that at times, events conspire to remind us of some universal truths. So we've learned that we're flexible. My colleagues are much better at using technology than ever before, and many have completely surpassed their own expectations of what they can deliver remotely. The vast majority of our students are now seeing more of exactly how technology can be used for purposeful educational reasons, and not just for loafing about on social media. We've learned that we're resilient. We're not the first human beings to face a pandemic or the struggles of war. And the history of our species tells us that when challenges come along, we always find a way to succeed. We find a way to overcome those challenges, and we're doing so as a race, as a species, with COVID-19. We've learned that we begin to understand what sustains us at times like this. I've told you so many times how much I've loved my job. I've never complained about the demands of being your head teacher, because it was my choice to do it. And there are so many brilliant and enjoyable aspects of being your head teacher. But I've had to make so many decisions over the past few months that I never thought I would have to make. I've been hugely out of my comfort zone, and I've found a lot of things difficult. At times like this, where do we draw our energy, inspiration, and hope from? So that we can continue to support ourselves and others around us. For me, my comfort comes from my family, my friends, my colleagues, and from God. Isaiah tells us, "Don't you know? Haven't you heard? The Lord will not grow tired and weary. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength." We've learned that we achieve more by working together, students, parents, and staff. We've all faced monumental challenges over the past 4 months. None of us has been through this before, and there are things we may have done slightly differently now we know what we know. But our mistakes have been honest mistakes, made with the best of intentions. We've relearned that we really need our schools. A school as an institution is an anchor in our lives. That we need the structure to our lives that school brings us. The school is much more than a simple academic experience. It's where we socialise with friends. It's where we laugh together, worry together, learn together. We've learned that education is something that we should not and cannot take for granted. It is precious. It's a gift. We've learned some other things. That we're possibly better at cutting hair than we thought we were. Some of us have physically grown a couple of inches in the past 4 months. Not all of us. We've learned we can survive without live sport on TV, just about. And we've relearned that school is still a journey of 1,000 days. You didn't expect me to get through a whole talk without mentioning that, surely. All that remains is for me to say well done on your achievements this year, and to hope that you're able to enjoy your summer break. Heartfelt thanks to all of our stakeholders, our brilliant students who make our job a joy to do, their parents who've done such a great job in supporting them over the past 4 months, my excellent colleagues who've continued to work as hard as ever, but in very different ways. Your school, Hertford Church of England High School, has remained open every weekday since lockdown began. And we've always pushed to the legal limit the number of students we can have in school. But without all of you here, it just hasn't been the same. We cannot wait to see you all back at school in September, where you belong. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Holland. I will now call upon your head of house to reflect upon the academic year.
Good morning, Red House, and welcome to parents and carers who have come to celebrate with us. Today is a celebration of what you have achieved this year in school and also at home. Achievement is usually associated with ability, but underlying that achievement is hard work and application. Achievement can be in all different ways. It may be great levels in subjects, an improvement in attendance, settling into a new school, making new friends, going on a trip or growing in confidence, and that is all to be celebrated. This year, it is also about saying well done for how you've coped with the difficulties we've encountered, for keeping up with your online learning, logging onto your Zoom lessons, keeping a routine, taking part in challenges and competitions, and most of all, staying kind to people at home and supporting your friends. This year, as your head of house, it proved to be the start of another successful and rewarding one, due in the main to the conscientious, considerate and kind-hearted members of Red House. So year seven, you were beginning to settle in, to find your feet, know your way around the school. Some of you joined new clubs and started to build new friendships. It's not the start of high school that you envisaged, as none of us did, but the majority of you have engaged with learning from home and have stayed in touch with your tutor. And the top two achievement point winners this year in 7H was Zoe Broughton and Isabel Pope, and in 7A it went to Amber LaRose and Zach Nokia. Year 8. Great attendance and a willingness to take part in everything, combined with a majority of you behaving in an excellent way. You've been hugely successful on desk duty. I'm always very proud to see how well you represent the school on these occasions. It's a really important job, as you are the face that visitors see. In 8H, the top achievement point winners were Sophie Jones and Anna Smith for the second year in a row. And in 8A were Imogen Davis and Lily Carter. Year 9, you've had another great year. You have chosen your options and will need to be ready in September to start working hard towards your GCSEs. Your behaviour is very good, with Lucy Kappa and Maddie Yates being the top conduct point winners for 9H, and in 9A, Alice Webster and Sean Thomas for the second year running. Your target for next year is to build on your achievements and attendance to ensure success at the start of your GCSEs. Our Year 9s have a really important role to play as buddies to our new Year 7s in September. The Year 7s will rely on the buddies for their help and advice when settling in and finding their way around. Thank you to last year's buddies, Beth, Zach, Lauren and Isabel, for helping the current Year 7s to settle in so quickly. You were doing a great job and expect you to continue to support them over the next 2 years. We have had our Year 6 induction evening for parents and pupils via Zoom this year. This was something new, but it worked fantastically, and we look forward to welcoming them into school for an induction day at the end of August, when we will have our new buddies in place. Year 10. You have been an excellent year. Some of you have applied for a prefect role, and of course will be applying for house and sports captain roles. I'm sure that you will embrace your roles and will be a credit to Red House and the school. You give up your lunch times, your evenings, and take on more tasks while studying for GCSEs. You set a really good example to pupils further down the school, giving them something to aim for when they're in their last year in school. Good luck to all Year 10s as you enter your last year at Hertford Church of England High School, with many opportunities to look forward to. Combined with hard work and our top achievement point scorers in 10H were Katie Turner and Nina Martin, and Mary Smith and Anna Yesayev for 10A. So, have we succeeded in hitting our targets for the house and school? Well, obviously this has been different. We've had other challenges and competitions to take part in during our time at home. Your attendance was very good, with 36 pupils hitting 100% attendance. 7A achieved over 97%, and 7A, 8H, 9H, and 9A all achieved over 96% attendance. So you were very nearly there. You were very busy in the short time we had here at school. A lot of you have been to school council meetings and representatives, charity form and sports reps for your tutor groups. Many of you have taken part in parents' evenings, members of the choir and orchestra performed at the Christmas carol service and the Hertford Victorian Christmas. Whilst we've been in lockdown, there have been several competitions to keep you busy. We had various pupils who have taken part in the music competition, and the winners for the solo instrument were Nina Martin, 10H, first place, and Mary Smith, second place. And in the arrangement composition category, we had Eben Loftus gaining second place for Year 7. In the intermediate maths challenges, we had Anna Yevseyev achieving silver, and bronze went to Mary Smith and Grace Verintoy. Mary also gained highly commended in a senior maths challenge with Liverpool University, and Anna Smith received merit for the same challenge, so well done. 12 of you entered the MFL challenge over lockdown, which was fantastic, with Charlie Francis coming first. Anna Smith and Zoe Broughton were runners-up. Thank you to all those who entered and gained us a huge 125 points, putting us first place, which is a fantastic effort, so thank you very much. Zara Jones had consistently produced phenomenal English work and has also won our school poetry by heart competition. She won the regional award and received a special commendation in the national finals. In October, she'll hopefully be heading to a finalist celebration. In the virtual sports day, year 8 came second, and special mention goes to Anna Smith, and we were third for year 7, 9 and 10. Other pupils who have represented their sport at a higher level are Zoe Broughton, Flynn Loftus, Anna Smith and Mary Smith for athletics. In gymnastics, we have Lottie Purdy and Kelsey Seddon, and Eleanor Bradbury in rugby and Zach Williams for basketball. You have shown concern for others. You helped to raise the most money at the Christmas fair by bringing in gifts and supporting our stall after school. During lockdown, Erin from Year 7 has also raised money for charity. It is important to me that you continue thinking and supporting others in the local and wider community. So, you were here when you could be, most of you were on time, and you had a positive and polite attitude around school. You've been prepared. Were you good? Well, yes, on the whole you were. This is what pleases me so much. We have a huge amount of achievement points, and I know that I'm very proud of you all. You always looked smart, you worked hard, and enjoyed everything that school has to offer. Importantly, you care. You care about school and you care about each other. You should feel proud, as I do, to be part of such a great team. Your aims for next year are to keep trying your best in all that you do, to take part, be involved for yourself, but also for the house, to keep your attendance high so you can achieve your potential in your subjects, and to work together as a team that cares and takes responsibility for each other, something that I think lots of people have learned during this lockdown time. Over the summer, I'd really like you to be involved with the P Department's virtual stadium tour. A lot of our tutors are very active and sporty, so I know they'll help us with this challenge. It feels really good to be all working towards something together, even though it's virtual. So please keep updating your steps. Miss Boyd has already started us off. Let this year, 2020, be a learning curve in our life. A year in which we reset the priorities of our life. Our health, family, and personal care should always take the topmost position among our priorities. We must appreciate equality in thought, word, and action without being biased towards our community, religion, or skin colour. We must follow our principles in life and stay committed to them. Our lives must be a testament to continuous learning. So thank you to parents and carers for your support, and to your hard-working tutors, teaching assistants, and to Mrs. Lewis, our pastoral manager, who has given you so much time, help and support in school and also whilst you've been at home. I really look forward to welcoming you back in September. Thank you, Red House. It has been an absolute pleasure to be your head of house, and I look forward to the successes of next year.
Thank you and congratulations to you all. At the start of lockdown, members of staff recorded in isolation a version of Lean On Me for our students to tell them we are still here to support them, to encourage them, and to tell them we believe in them even when we can't do it in person. Usually we'd now read out the individual names of all our students and invite them up on the stage to collect their certificates for attainment, achievement, effort, attendance, and service to school and community. Instead, you will receive your certificates along with your programme from today and your school tutor report in the post over the next few days. Congratulations to each and every one of you for all your achievements. We are immensely proud of you all.
In these unusual times, think about the words from the wonderful Maya Angelou and try to be a rainbow in someone else's cloud. We hope hope this is a little rainbow for you.
Delighted to introduce two musical pieces from our students. This year we should have held our inter-house music competition on the last day of the spring term. Unfortunately this could not take place, and instead 26 of you sent your music entries in to Miss Philippou and the competition took place virtually. Although the judges found it incredibly difficult to choose the winners, they did, and today we are sharing a selection of their performances with you. During the first piece of music, the winners of the Subject Attainment and Achievement Prizes will be shown on your screen. These are awarded to the highest attaining and achieving students across each subject and year group. Huge congratulations to you all. During the second piece of music, we will be sharing our lockdown legends. These are the three students across each subject and year group who have been nominated by their teachers for outstanding contributions during the home learning period. We will also be sharing our house prize winners. These prizes have been awarded to recognise individuals in the challenges that have faced our students during this time away from school. Enjoy the music.
Thank you.
This year saw the introduction of the new Hertford Church of England High School House Cup. This has involved a wide variety of competitions in art, drama, English, history, geography, maths, MFL, music, PE and RS, with winners and runners-up achieving house points. There have been so many outstanding contributions, both whilst you were in school and when you were working from home, and I'm delighted with how many of you have participated across the range of subjects. Congratulations to everyone who has taken part, and here are the results. In second place, the runner-up is Yellow House. Congratulations, Mr. Armstrong, and all our Yellow House students. And in first place, for the first ever Hertford Church of England High School House Cup, the awards go to Red House. Congratulations, Ms. Daniels, and all your Red House students. I am sure you'll be delighted to receive your cup in September. We will now return to the Veritas Library, where our Vice Chair of Governors, Ms. Ruth Stanley, will propose the thanks.
Welcome to this celebration, albeit virtually. Normally, we're in a very hot hall, and you are concentrating on not tripping up on the steps, smiling, and getting back to your seats as quickly as possible. I'm concentrating on getting your names right. I'm missing that experience. For those of you who have achieved 100% attendance, well done. Governors are always very proud of this and we congratulate you. Attendance and attainment go hand in hand, and it is wonderful to hear how many of you have exceeded the school target of 97%. It has been an unusual year, but you have achieved so much during lockdown and the 7 months of this academic year. You should be justly proud of this. There are so many achievement points for your excellent behaviour in lessons and around school. It was a pleasure to listen to the musical performances of the winners of the Interhouse Music Competition. Again, you have the challenge of recording your performances at home, just like Ed Sheeran and others have done this year. Your art and drama entries are of a high standard, and it is so important to have a varied experience for your college applications as you carve out your future careers. On behalf of the governing body, I hope you enjoy the summer, stay safe, and we look forward to welcoming you back in September. Caritas and Veritas await your return.
Thank you, Ms. Stanley. I would now like to invite our Vice Chair, Reverend Smith, to lead us in our school prayer from across the road at the Vicarage.
Love and truth. Our students wear those words on their blazers because it's what we seek to be, loving and truthful people. We need help to live like that. And in our school prayer, we ask for that help from the God who in Jesus Christ is Caritas et Veritas, love and truth. Let me lead us in our school prayer. Almighty God, thank you for our school, for friendship and learning. Teach us to love you and to serve each other. Guide us in your truth and teach us wisdom. Give us humble hearts and honest lives. Show us your love and help us to practice it. Through the grace of Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Smith. As we end our commendation day today, I would like to thank Mr. Huns, Miss Stanley, Reverend Smith, Mr. Holland and your heads of houses for their contributions. And of course, our outstanding musicians for allowing us to share their music. I would like to thank all our school staff for the part they play every day in helping you fulfil your potential. And I would like to thank your parents and carers for supporting you and encouraging you to be the best you can each and every day. And not least for teaching you when we could not do so. I am sure they will all be delighted school is opening again in September. But mostly I would like to thank you, our students. The reason we come to work every day is to be part of your lives and help you make the right decisions to fulfil your immense potential. If there is one thing we've all learned over these last few months, it is that we need to show resilience. We need to work hard every day to achieve our dreams and aspirations, and that no matter what life throws at us, we need to be ready to face it in Caritas et Veritas, love and truth. Thank you for joining us today. We will end with Hertford Church of England High School's amazing virtual orchestra performance of We Are the Champions. We wish you all a wonderful summer holiday and look forward to welcoming you and our New Year Sevens all together again in September.